Hello, freak bitches.
Did you see what this shit Bob Arum said today?
No.
Said we have a boxing as an enemy, and it's the UFC. The UFC is the enemy of boxing. He's such a stupid old dummy.
Fuck Bob Arum.
He's just such a dummy. You just got 6.5 million pay-per-view buys from Mayweather versus McGregor in a boxing match. Yeah. So you tell me how the UFC is the enemy. You silly
goose.
They just
fucking helped you out, dude.
Yeah.
Made boxing cool again.
It definitely, I guarantee you, it bumped up Canelo Alvarez and Triple G.
Oh, absolutely.
I can't wait. We just watched the 24/7.
Oh, yeah, me too.
I'm
so pumped.
Who you taking?
Boy, I don't know. Look, Gennady Golovkin is a motherfucker, dude. But Canelo Alvarez gets better all the time. He's a younger guy. You know, he looked fucking sensational against Amir Khan. He's looked sensational against everybody except Floyd.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, Floyd got him to drain himself.
Yeah.
Got him to go all the way down to 150 or like 152 or something.
52,
like that.
Right? And never cut down that far.
Yeah, he cut down way low and he just looked sluggish. And Floyd is the best boxer pretty much ever.
Yeah, you know, just definitely. He is.
Boxed him up.
Game plan, stuck to the game plan.
Yeah, and just looked beautiful.
Dude, Triple G's interviews are hilarious.
That's
great. He's like traditional, like Russian. I think, you know, it sounds like exactly how you.
Max, I'm here for a big drama show.
Yeah, exactly.
Max, of He's course.
Like, I think it will be a good fight.
Good
you
fight
know?
For the fans. That's what I'm here for. Muchos gracias, my friends. Mexicans love Triple G.
He
fights like fucking Julio Cesar Chavez, man.
He's a savage.
He's a fucking animal. Body punching, ripping shots.
Well, who do you think's going to get it, Cody?
Man, I think, honestly, Canelo. I don't know. I just think Canelo. Triple G is a beast. I don't know. I think Canelo.
But you like Canelo. Why do you like Canelo in this?
I just like his pressure, his body punches, you know, how he flows. He throws a lot of hooks. A lot of, like, I'm a big hook guy. So, like Mike Tyson and I used to watch all Mike stuff, hooks. And Canelo does, too.
He throws some creative stuff too.
Right. He does.
I did that. I started doing a move off of watching Canelo. He throws like a fake hook to an uppercut. So it's like this and it goes like that because the guy will cover here and it comes right up the middle.
Mm.
And I mean, mine didn't look as good as his. I did a bunch against Scotty Jorgensen when I fought and it looked like I was just winding my arm up like this. But it's like, boom. But he has a bunch of little tricky, subtle things that he does. I like Canelo too.
He also has ring generalship. Like, that's huge for me. Like, you can knock people out fast or have good combos, but the way that you take the octagon or the ring and, like, stalk them and then impose your will on them, his presence in there, he knows where he's at all the time.
Yeah. What's interesting to me about this fight is this is the first time that he's fought a guy who's world-class that is a brutal power puncher like him, who's bigger than him, who's going to come towards him. You know, whereas he fought Floyd. Floyd was a smaller guy, but just way craftier and slicker with his style. And, you know, it was an interesting fight, but ultimately it wasn't like the most exciting fight because Floyd just kind of outboxed him. I think this is going to be a bang 'em up fight.
Phone booth fight.
Yeah, I think they're going to come towards each other, and it's going to get crazy.
Yeah.
For real, this is like the highest stakes fight in boxing because you have two murderous punchers in their prime, Gennady Golovkin undefeated, the only person Canelo lost to is Floyd.
Floyd,
right. So, is that his only loss?
Yeah, it's his only loss, and
he's
it's
been
a decision.
Fighting since he was 15 professionally. You know, 15.
Phenomenal,
years
phenomenal Crazy. Fight. I mean, just such a good fight. I cannot wait for this fight.
Yeah,
I'm so amped up.
That's when Oscar tweeted about, you know, he was all butthurt about it. I was like, dude, we're still gonna watch GGG and Canelo.
This is why they're all fools. If Oscar just said this is great for boxing, this is great for everybody, then everybody would have been fine. Instead, these guys create enemies,
I know.
You know, and say this is a disgrace, this is a fixed
power
fight.
Power numbers.
Right.
They're saying Floyd fixed the fight, and you know, they're like,
are they still
Oscar's
saying that?
Oscar's saying some crazy shit. Yeah. Oscar's losing his mind.
How about Dana calling him out?
Yeah. Dana's like, is he doing blow and cross-dressing?
Dude.
What is he doing? Dana's a savage.
Dude, he's
a savage
on there.
Bro.
He'll call him
he
on some of
zero fucks. Yeah.